Hello friends, in our previous session we discussed on two methods of financial statement analysis, that is comparative statement analysis and funds flow analysis. We understood how these methods are useful for evaluating and examining financial performance with the help of income statement and balance sheet. In this session we will go through the next techniques of financial statement analysis, that is common size statement and trend analysis. Before we begin with these methods, let me quickly revise on what is meant by FSA, that is financial statement analysis. FSA is a systematic and critical examination of the performance contained in the financial statements with a view to provide effective and more meaningful information to its different users. It is basically a postmortem of the transactional activities of an enterprise as disclosed in the financial statements, so as to judge the operational ability, profitability, wealth, managerial efficiency and overall performance of the enterprise more clearly. We had compared this activity with that of dissection of frog, where the dissection is undertaken in order to understand biological system of the animal. Now let us approach to the third method of financial statement analysis, that is common size statement. Through comparative analysis of financial statements, a comparative study of different items or elements of financial statement of two or more years can be made. But the relative position of each item of the financial statement cannot be known. For example, if I say that I scored 87% in unit 1 and 90% in unit 2 examination. Further, I scored 70 marks in the mathematics and 78 in science in unit 1 exam and 98 marks in mathematics and 94 in science during unit 2. Further, the mathematics marks are out of 100 and science out of 120. Now, with the help of comparative study, you would be able to interpret my academic performance horizontally, that is of unit 1 and unit 2 exams. But what will not be clearly revealed is that what is the proportional share of mathematics marks in my total performance, or proportion share of science in the total performance. Again, mathematics marks are out of 100 while science marks are out of 120. Some other subject may be out of 50. Now, how do we bring all these marks on common lines of comparison? This answer is given by the common size statement analysis. CSS analysis is a process of vertical study of relational performance of each element of financial statement with that of other. There are two forms of CSS analysis. One, common size income statement, and two, common size balance sheet. These statements are termed as common size, as each item in such statements is represented as a percentage of one chosen base item. In case of common size income statement, generally net sales is considered as a base item. Profit is a base line of any business and profit is generated from sales. Therefore, firm is always interested to compare relative performance of all other items with sales. On the other hand, in case of common size balance sheet, generally the total of balance sheet is considered as the base item. Given pertinent information can be derived from CSS. 1. Absolute figures of the items appearing in the financial statements of two or more years or two or more firms, and 2. Percentage figure of every item in the financial statements as per a percentage of the pre-selected base item. Friends, what we need to keep it in mind is that comparative statement is the horizontal analysis while common size statement is a vertical analysis. Now, let us take a simple example to understand this technique of analysis. Common size income statement, example 1. Common size income statement of firm A and firm B. We can see this table where all these items are given in the comparative analysis. Now, tentative interpretation. In this example, we have presented income statement of two firms, where column 2 shows absolute figures and column 3 shows percentage of each element against sales. The reason why this analysis is termed as common size is that all the figures are converted into a common denominator, that is 100. This makes analysis quite simpler and meaningful. In our example, some aspects can be analyzed. Those are: 1. Sales are taken as base and therefore its value is 100%. The gross profit is 55% of sales in case of firm A and 60% in case of firm B. 2. Operating profit derived after deducting operating expenses comes to 37.5% and 46.67% for firm A and B respectively. 3. Profit after tax in comparison of sales is 15% in case of firm A and 20% in case of firm B. 4. The performance of firm B is better than firm A due to cost control. In other words, firm B's expenses are proportionately less in comparison with sales as against firm A. With this method of analysis, results can be easily interpreted and examined using a common base of percentage. Now, let's make a tentative interpretation. 1. In case of composition of assets, it can be seen that the proportion of fixed asset to the total asset is same in both the firms. 2. There is difference in case of proportion of investment and current assets in that of total assets. 3. Now, if you compare liabilities of both the companies, it can be seen that in case of long term liability, firm A has 55% share of proprietary fund and around 28% of borrowed fund, whereas firm B's composition is 70-18. This shows that firm A relies more heavily on external debt as compared to firm B. 4. Similarly, composition of current liability in total liability is 17% and 12% of firm A and B respectively. This shows that firm A's proprietary fund contribution in total liabilities is less as compared to firm B. This can be a tentative interpretation of common size financial statement. The interpretations may change according to the specific requirement of this analyst. Now, let us discuss difference between comparative statement and common size statement analysis. Comparative statement is a form of horizontal analysis and common size statement is a form of vertical analysis. Comparative statement is a comparison of different elements of financial statement between two or more years, and common size statement is a comparison of different elements of financial statement with one chosen base item of the same year. Comparative statement fails to exhibit relative importance of an individual component in the total, and in common size statement, it shows the relative importance of each item of such statement in the total. Change in values of different items in two different years are shown both in absolute as well as percentage terms. Changes in value of different items are shown as per a percentage of a base item. Comparative statement is very popular technique of FSA, and common size statement is not so popular as compared to comparative statement. Friends, now let us consider advantages and disadvantages of common size statement. First, let us consider advantages of CSS analysis. 1. Common size statement exhibits relative significance of every item in the FS in percentage terms of the base figure. 2. In common size income statement, all items are converted in the percentage terms of sales. Such conversion helps an analyst to know how much portion of the sales is used up in cost of sales, operating expenses, interest and tax. 3. In common size balance sheet, every item is presented in terms of the total assets and liabilities. This helps an analyst to know how much percentage of total asset has been apportioned between current and fixed assets and how much percentage of the total liabilities is payable to the owners and the outsiders. 4. Nature of capital structure can be known at a glance, that is, the proportion of own capital and debt capital in total capital structure. Now, let us see disadvantages of common size statement. 1. Under this statement, the relative importance of each component of financial statement on the whole is exhibited, but no comparative study is done between the years. 2. In such statement, the time value of money is not considered at all. 3. This analysis does not prove to be very useful for any important decision making. 4. It is not useful when it comes to make any segment wise analysis. We have been comparing methods of financial analysis with that of academic performance evaluation. So, let us continue with the same example. Now, in comparative statement, we had compared marks of unit 1 exam with that of unit 2 exam in common size analysis. We studied relative performance of each subject in comparison with overall performance. If I want to study performance of any particular subject, say mathematics or science, throughout my academic tenure, then above two methods would not be helpful. Trained analysis, as the name suggests, is a study of trend or pattern of movement of a particular financial element. Trend analysis is a form of comparative analysis of financial statements between two or more years. It indicates the trend of an individual item of the financial statements over a period of time. It helps to analyze the trend of each such item and thus helps the management in the process of present and future policy making. Steps in computing trend values or percentages. 1. Generally, a year that has not faced any abnormal business situation is considered as a base year. The monetary amount of the financial item of the base year is assigned the value of 100. If there are any abnormal price fluctuations, then these fluctuations are normalized by making necessary adjustments. Trend percentage is equal to current year's figure divided by base year's figure, that is 100. Based on the trend derived, conclusions are drawn by the analyst. Let us understand this technique with the help of an example. Let us calculate trend percentage from the given information. We can see in this table, the sales per year is given, cost of sales is given, and inventory is also given. You can see where the amount of 2009 is given, trend is considered as 100, amount is say 4 lakhs, trend is 100, amount is 2 lakhs, and trend is 100. And then we can see furthermore in the years of 2010, 11, 12, 13, and 14, and we can see the trends given ahead of each amount. In this example, we have taken three elements of income statements, that is sales, cost of sales and inventory. From the trend analysis, we can derive some interpretations like all the financial elements are showing an increasing trend. Second, if we compare growth trend of sales and cost of sales, then we can say that cost of sales is growing at much more speed than sales. For example, sales of 2014 are 183% of the base year, whereas cost of sales has increased by 226% compared to base year. This trend can be seen in each year's growth rate. One can say that there is a need to control proportionate value of cost of sales. On the other hand, inventory is also rising at a steady rate. But if we compare its growth within that of sales, then it is quite satisfactory. This is because when the sales have increased by 183% in 2014, subsequent increase in inventory is only 140%. Now, let us take an example of some of the elements of balance sheet. Table showing trend of three elements of balance sheet: current assets, current liabilities, and investments. We can see in the year 2009, 10, 11, and 12, amount of current assets is given, trend is given, then again amount of current liabilities is given, the trend is given, and amount of investments is given, and trend is also given. Friends, let us interpret some aspects from this example. All the three elements are showing increasing trend for the given period. Now, if we compare current assets with the current liabilities, it can be seen that current liabilities are growing at faster pace than current assets. And the company shows an increasing trend in case of long-term investments. We can say that the surplus generated is invested in the form of long-term investments. As you can see, that working capital is calculated by subtracting current liabilities from current assets. In our example, if we calculate the working capital trend, then it can be seen that the amount of working capital is negative from 2009 to 2012, and this negative amount shows an increasing trend, that is, it has increased from 154% to 340%. This shows that the company heavily trades on current liabilities to meet its need for current assets. This also shows that the company has good cash management and high credibility among creditors. All examples shows that the firm has good asset management system. Table showing trends of working capital. You can see in this table, current assets, current liabilities, working capital, and trend also. The trends are varying from 100%, 154, 162, and 320. Friends, as already mentioned several times, that this interpretation depends on the purpose for which the analysis is done. So, the user of this analysis may change its approach of interpretation according to the purpose and focus on this exercise. Now, let us understand some of the advantages and disadvantages of trend analysis. Let us consider first advantages of trend analysis. Trend analysis helps in analyzing the growth in the financial activities of the firm at a glance. Graphical presentation of trend line helps the management to take a quick decision on the concerned issue. Trend values not only help the management in any important decision making, but in the controlling process as well. And trend analysis proves to be very useful for taking rational investment decisions. Let us see disadvantages of trend analysis. Under trend analysis, choosing a base year is a very difficult task. It's not easy to identify the impact of inflation on the trend data, and thus the result might be misleading. For example, increase in sales turnover may be due to increase in prices rather than increase in unit sales. Changes in market conditions are not considered in trend analysis. Friends, let us conclude this session. We have covered two methods of FSA, that is common size statement analysis and trend analysis, in this session. Our next session will be fully dedicated to ratio analysis, which is the most popularly used tool of FSA. Thank you.